It is something similar to the mentality of the Nazi. When Hitler, he owned offensive arms, he used them in attacking London, in destroying completely Coventry, in killing millions of the Europeans. And that is the same mentality now prevailing in Israel. There they have superiority in offensive weapons, and there is no doubt that the United States are responsible about this matter, because they are supplying with all these offensive weapons. And these people, they want just to kill, as exactly Hitler was trying to do, to scare the people, as Hitler tried to scare the British, and they want to scare the Arabs.
But there does seem some attempt by Israel to extend the olive branch of peace towards you. There is talk, for example, of hotlines being established or compensation for the victims. How do you think the Arab world is reacting to these offers?
I don't see, very frankly, any olive branches or anything concerning the olives, but all what we can see, hotline, that is a fire line, crimes, attacking people, that's the only offer to the Arabs.
So from what you're saying, it doesn't seem that the Arab world is prepared to forgive and forget, as perhaps Israel would like them to.
No, it's not a question, as I said, of killing people. It's the question of the mentality behind this action. They did that not only to kill, but in order to scare the Arabs so that they can surrender to their main demands, that's annexing Arab territories. So if we want peace in the area, the first thing that must be done, that Israel will withdraw from all the Arab territories occupied by Israel now.
But what about the shooting down of the airliner, though? Do you think that this is going to cause permanent damage to relations in the Middle East, or is it an incident that will soon be forgotten?
It cannot be forgotten, because, as I said, it's not only an incident. It is a policy. So it cannot be forgotten. It's a policy, I said, it's a mentality. It's something which will be repeated every day.